First, we're going to check for danger. So checking for danger, we make sure that we are safe as well, because the last thing you want to do is you don't want to become a casualty yourself. The next step is checking for response. If you know the casualty's name, use their name. Just ask them, hello, hello, can you hear me? And you go close to both sides of the ear with your mouth, because in case the casualty cannot hear you, ear is blocked on one side. That's why you go to both sides. Then if the casualty is still not responding to your voice, you can pinch their earlobes or you tap the collarbone to get a response. And then you shout for help and you ask your bystander to call 999 or 112 for emergency services. The next step is we want to check if the casualty has got nothing in their mouth which could block their airway. So we could take that out. Then we do what we call the head tilt chin lift. So you have one hand on the forehead and two fingers on the chin. And you do the head tilt chin lift by tilting the head back slightly. And then we want to check for normal breathing. So we check for normal breathing for 10 seconds and we look, listen and feel for 2 to 3 normal breaths. And how we do this is by coming close with my ear to the casualty's mouth and I face the feet because I want to feel the breaths on my ear and I also want to see the chest rising at the same time, and I count for 10 seconds. And we want to get at least 2 to 3 normal breaths. If the casualty is breathing and still unconscious, we would move the casualty into a recovery position. If the casualty is not breathing, we would start with chest compressions right away.